Hey guys, this is actually my second video on this topic of polygamy and why it shouldn't be legalized, why it shouldn't be recognized by the US government as marriage. And I'm doing this second part because I do feel like the first video was just not well done. I still stand by a good amount of the points that I made in the first part. But I do feel like I could make stronger points because I feel like my perspective on this has somewhat evolved in a way. And I think that's great. I feel like, you know, the important thing for me in my life, my philosophy is to never be certain on anything. Never be absolutely certain on anything. Should always, you know, you have certainty in your life, but it should never be 100%. It should, if you're really certain about something, it should be like 95%, 99%. But you always leave a little room for doubt, always. Because I do view absolute certainty in an idea as one of the most dangerous things in the world. If you have absolute certainty in an idea, you have the potential to become a terrorist. Anyway, that aside, the stronger arguments I want to make here, which I didn't mention in the previous video, I think I didn't think to mention in the previous video because at this point actually compares polygamy with the issue of gay marriage and homosexuality. And in the previous video, I wanted to kind of make the point that polygamy is a totally separate debate than gay marriage. So I could make arguments against legalizing polygamy without mentioning gay marriage, right? That's kind of the point I wanted to make. But I don't necessarily have to make that point. So comparison is important here. The distinction to me, why it's important is polygamy, unlike homosexuality or gay marriage, is not about sexual orientation. If you want to have a polygamous relationship, you want to have it. It's like something you choose to do, but you don't have a predisposition towards it. It's not your identity. A person doesn't really have a choice whether they want to be gay or bi or transgender or transsexual. It's their identity that they can't change once they pretty much figure it out about themselves. You know, and for most people, figuring it out happens very young. They're born with it, but figuring out what they're born with, figuring out their identity. For example, I was born Asian. But figuring out the fact that I'm actually Asian actually took me quite a while. You know, because everyone else were around me like that. It was such a weird concept to me. I finally came to America and was just like, whoa, all these people look different than me. And they speak a whole completely different language than me. And that's when I like went through this identity. It's like, oh, so I have this special identity where I'm actually from a different continent. I was born that way. But figuring that out took me some time. It's kind of like that with homosexuality. People are actually kind of born with their sexual orientation. Figuring that out takes some time. Figuring that I was straight, I guess, took me some time. I guess it was, you know, it's not something that we actually think about that much because straight people don't have to think about that as much as gay people do in a society where being straight is just something that's expected out of you, and being gay is considered abnormal. But it is something that it needs to be developed. Polygamy is not like that. That's why marriage equality argument for marriage equality makes sense for homosexuality. For polygamy, it kind of doesn't. It wouldn't be considered discrimination because polygamy is something you choose to do. And whether you choose to do or not, that's perfectly fine, but government should there is no argument that like because government doesn't give marriage benefits and rights to polygamy, that is discriminating based on a person's identity. Because that is the argument for gay marriage. That's the argument to make it constitutional. Homosexuality is not protected under the 14th Amendment. It's not a federally protected class, but we're trying to make it to be. because it is an identity. So if we include that in the 14th Amendment, then it's unconstitutional to not allow gay marriage. But imagine trying to add polygamy as a federally protected class. That doesn't make any sense whatsoever. I mean, we do have some things we're not born with. For example, religion is a federally protected class, right? You can't discriminate someone based on their religion. So that's why a Catholic is allowed. It's legal for a Catholic person to marry a Jewish person. Is someone born a Jewish person? Not technically, no. They're raised to be Jewish or they're raised to be Christian. But religious identity is definitely something you can change. So I'm not saying that just because you can't change it, you know, you can discriminate on that. Polygamy is something you can change. You can choose to be polygamous or not. It is not a sexual orientation. It is not an identity. But religion can be considered an identity. That's why I think it's okay to consider that as a federally protected class. Age is federally protected. Gender identity. Well, actually, no, not yet. We're trying to make that happen. Gender identity and homosexuality, sexual orientation, actually, should be federally protected class. That's the argument for gay marriage. That argument does not work with polygamy, because polygamy is not a federally protected class, nor should it be. I guess you can try to tie it under religion, but religion is about faith and belief, not about its practices. For example, the Mayan religion requires that I sacrifice a teenage girl every year and burn her to death. That's a religious practice. Is it legal in America? No, it's not. Are you able to have a Mayan belief and you know, have Mayan religion be your religion? Yes, you're totally allowed to have that freedom. Religion and freedom doesn't mean that you have the freedom to do what the religion practices. You know what I mean? This is where it kind of gets complicated. But currently in America, it is legal. You have the freedom of religion, but you don't have the freedom of practicing a religious practice if that practice is harmful and illegal. With certain exceptions, certain Indian religions are able to use illicit substances, even though illicit substances to everyone else is illegal. There are certain exceptions. But for the most part, if a religion says, if there is a religion out there that preaches that homosexuality should be stoned to death and you need to go out there and kill them, you're free to have that belief, but you're not free to actually act upon that. That would be a criminal thing. So polygamy is like that. You're free to believe in polygamy. You're free to believe that polygamy is the best form of marriage. But currently, it's illegal to... Well, it's not illegal. You can have polyamorous relationships, but the government will not recognize polygamy as marriage. It's not legally recognized. So that's one point. Wow, there's actually a couple more points that I wanted to bring up, but I guess that one point, it took up so much time, so I guess I will make yet another video about why polygamy shouldn't be legalized. So, yeah, cheers.